face and scoop them into my mouth because the potatoes try to get away from me. I look like a hungry hippo. I think I'm gonna have to, so you'll have to excuse me. use of where I am. If there are little markers with the trail names on them, I'll be sure to remember what they're called. You know, just visual things that remind me of where I am. And for the longest time, that was in case I fell or broke my leg or something, you know what I mean, I got stuck and I needed help in that situation, and it was just sort of a back of the mind, you know, for later, just in case thing. But I've found myself the last couple of months basically playing out a scenario in my head where I'll think, okay, so if I start having a heart attack, I'll call 911 and I'll tell them, you know, what trail I'm at, what part of the trail I'm on, and where it splits. But then I'll start thinking to myself, well, there's a fork in the trail, and how do I tell them where I am in this particular part of that particular trail? How are they going to be able to find me? What if I forget? What if I am having a stroke and I start slurring my speech or forgetting things, or I just speaking nonsense? And I looked at that thought as it started to come yesterday, like it started to well up a little bit, just a small little bit of tightness in my chest, and I was like, wait a second. And I actually just observed the thought for a second, and I was like, wait a minute, I always used to observe things on the trail in case I fell, which is a lot more likely, like to break a leg or twist my ankle or something. Sleep.